The Morning Zoo, and once again here is Zoo Director Mark Heinzman. He's joining us with a friend from the zoo. It's a unique looking animal. Yes. Armadillo, right?
Yeah, this is a six-banded armadillo. This is Harvey.
And Harvey?
Yeah, Harvey the armadillo. Okay. They're originally from South America.
Uh-huh.
And as you can see, well, the name armadillo is Spanish for little armored one.
Uh-huh.
And as you can see, he's got quite a bit of armor on him.
Yes.
You know, he's covered pretty much head to tail and on his feet and everything else with armor plating. So he's a pretty well-reinforced little guy.
He's a busy guy.
Definitely.
He's a little uncomfortable right now. Are they usually this active?
Or? Yeah, they're active during the day. So this is right about the time where he would be getting up for the day and
okay.
You know, finding food, moving around, doing whatever. So I think he would prefer I let him down and run all over the studio, but I think you guys would prefer I don't do that. So I'm going to hold on to him for a little bit more.
Right, right. Tell us a little bit more about him. I mean, he's making a noise. You can hear. Is that?
Yeah, he's smelling is okay. What it is. And armadillos actually have terrible eyesight, terrible eyesight. They can't see hardly in front of their face. So they rely almost entirely on their scent. So his nose is constantly going. He's sniffing all the time. That's basically how he finds his way around. And you know, that's their main means of survival, actually.
Can I touch the armor?
Yeah.
Will that make him mad?
No, he's fine.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can see he's got some hair on his back, kind of coming through the armor there, and doesn't serve much of a purpose, really. It's pretty wispy in between. These guys actually, like as I mentioned, from South America, they're actually considered kind of a nuisance down there. They're similar to the moles we have up here.
Okay.
You know, they eat the crops from the fields, and they dig up the ground, and it kind of causes a lot of havoc
place.
And those
mm-hmm.
sorts of things. But, you know, we don't have them up here, so they're not as much of a pest for us. Obviously, we love them.
Yeah, except for at the zoo. Yeah, we can see them there. I know you guys just had the Easter egg hunt. We were out for that. It was a great event. Lots of people. What other things do you guys have coming up?
Well, we've got our Earth Day celebration coming up on the 21st, I believe, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
And that's Party for the Planet is what it's called, and that is our celebration of Earth Day, as I mentioned, and it's a chance for you to come out, learn about how you can live a greener life. You can help us in our mission to conserve the natural world and wild animals. And it's also a fun time too. You know, it's not just a lecture or anything like that. There's lots of fun activities for the kids.
Right.
There's things for the adults to do. It's a great event.
I know you guys are kind of waiting for the weather to warm up as well.
Yeah, we've had a few good days. We had a great weekend this past weekend, and you know. We've got some rain now, so we kind of can't get lucky here with this weather. First it was cold, now it's rainy. But hopefully soon it'll clear out again and it'll be some nice, sunny, warm days to come out and enjoy the zoo.
It'll turn around for sure. Well, thank you for bringing Harvey in.
You're welcome.
Mark Heinzman, the zoo director at Niabi Zoo. Right now, we also want to send out a big congratulations to our Zookeeper for a Day contest winner, Cheyenne Drolima from Morrison, Illinois. We'll get to work at the zoo for a day. So congratulations. That should be a lot of fun. But right now,